an inspiration to see that magazine. And Dwayne was telling me how tourism has gone up 42% in the last, how much? In the last 5 years. That's really remarkable. But it is it's a signal, I think, to all of us about what's happening in South Carolina. And in the past few years, I've had the opportunity to talk to a lot of people who are thinking about coming to the state and investing millions, even billions of dollars in the state, and they are thrilled by what they see when they come. And we've been discovered, and there's nothing we can do about it. And unless we mess it up, they're going to keep on coming. And what it takes is vision. So I got a little cute little story. They say in the Army, the only stupid question is the one you don't ask. Well, in law, if you do courtroom law, the only stupid question you ask is the one you don't already know the answer to. Any lawyers out there? You never ask a question that you don't know the answer to. Well, there's one of these Abe Lincoln type stories about the lawyer that was in there. It was representing the big guy who had gotten in the fight with the little guy, and the little guy had bitten his ear off. So the big guy's lawyer was asking questions of the witness who saw the fight. And he said, well, you were there that night and you saw the whole thing. He said, yeah, my vision's good, and I saw the whole thing. He said, where did it take place? He says, it's in the bar. Well, what were they doing? He said, they were fighting. Well, how close to me? He said, not from me to you, I was close. He said, well, did you actually see him bite the big guy's ear off? He said, well, no, I didn't. He turned to go sit down, thinking he'd won his case, and then he asked a question he didn't know the answer to. He said, well, how do you know he bit his ear off? He says, because I saw him spit it out. Well, his vision was good, and he saw what he saw. But the one point I want to make with you today is there's a lot of vision is represented in what is happening here, what we just saw on the video, and what we see in these magazines, and what we hear every day. And that is, people are coming to South Carolina, we've been discovered, we have things that don't have anywhere. You can't make it overnight. You can't even make it in several generations. I'm talking about great research universities. Our technical colleges started in 1961. There was some thinking involved there. That was Stan Smith, a businessman in Columbia, and Fritz Hollingsworth, two of the key people that pioneered that idea. But you keep on looking, and you see Charles Frazier back in 1956, who was instrumental in getting the bridge built to this island, which was bought long before, like a lot of our other low country islands and old plantations by New York and Wall Street industrialists that came down in the 20s and 30s and bought them for hunting preserves. But like Kiowa, this was for timber and those kind of things. Then they built the bridge, and then people started, and then sea pines developed with Mr. Frazier, and things went on from there. But more recently, we've seen vision up in Greenville, where they have the new bridge there. Built in 2004, I think. And there were people that invested. They could see what could happen. They could see what would happen if they cleaned up the Reedy River, which had caught on fire several times prior to that because of all the trash in it. And they built the walking bridge. We've seen the same kind of innovation and kind of progress and spirit in Columbia, where the old warehouse district just west of Assembly Street used to be nothing but warehouses, old tin buildings, railroad tracks. But somebody had an idea, somebody had the vision, and somebody could see it. So what I say to you is, let's keep this up. The tourism business in South Carolina is not tourism industry. There's always a debate about which is it. Is it the industrial industry? Is it tourism? Or is it agriculture? Which is, they're all in the 20 billions, and they all work together. And my view is, if we can collaborate and realize it is, you don't want to keep it small and keep it all. You want to open this up to everybody. There's plenty of room for all kind of competition and innovation in South Carolina in the great asset, or as the young people would say, the great platform we have right here with our climate, with the mountains, with the oceans, with the marshes, all of which can't be made or remade. You can't invent those. The institutions that we've added to it are remarkable. But the thing that these business people tell me is it's the people of South Carolina that bring them here. I'm talking about Germans and Japanese. Japanese have, I think, 180 companies here, but the Germans have 100. The German companies, 120, including BMW. It's popping out a new BMW every 61.7 seconds. Can you imagine that? Every 61.7 seconds. But it is a remarkable story that is going on. Athletic championships, golf championships, heritage is unique. It's the only, you know, you can't talk a lot of business. The Masters is a great thing, but you can't really talk at the Masters. But if the heritage, you can talk, you can yell, you can do business, you can do all those things, and see great golf at the same time. There are more unique things in our state than anywhere else. And Strom Thurmond used to talk about it years ago. More battles, more skirmishes and fights in South Carolina in the Revolutionary War than any other state. So all those things make for a very long story to describe how we've gotten where we are and why we are at the head of the pack right now. South Carolina has more potential for economic growth and development, prosperity, which means happiness, than any place in the country. And that's why people are coming here. And if they come and visit, they come back and visit. And if they come back and visit, eventually they retire, eventually they invest money, eventually they go back to Germany or Italy or France or wherever, or China or Russia. Well, not too many Russians in China. They go all over the world and say, South Carolina is on fire. You've got to go to South Carolina. So to quote that great philosopher and also country music singer, Tim McGraw, I like it, I love it, I want some more of it. And if we don't mess it up, if we can, my job is to keep taxes low, the regulations few, education strong, and keep people happy, keep them safe and secure in their homes and businesses, keep their property secure. If I can do that and with your help, and if you can do what you have been doing, just keep it up and have that vision that there's no stopping this state right now. The South is the place that is growing, the southeastern states is in all the statistics. In South Carolina, according to the investors who are coming with millions and billions of dollars, this is the number one spot. This is the one they look forward to begin with. And it's because of what you're doing. So thank you.